Hi, I'm Ankita Pathak, an economist with Edelweiss. Recently, we came up with a report on commodity reflation where we are betting big that commodity cycle is now bottoming out. The core commodity index is now trading at prices that were last seen at the beginning of this century. Our hypothesis is based on three major events playing out. One, dollar will weaken from here on. Number two, the global growth will revive. And finally, the commodity will hit its cyclical lows. In this video, we'll take you through all these events and how you can play commodity reflation in Indian markets. The first major driver of commodity prices playing out will be weakening of dollar. Commodity prices and dollar always move in opposite direction. So, but why will dollar weaken here on? One, dollar has formed a cyclical top. If we look at the dollar index, the tops in dollar are about 16 years apart. This tells us the dollar had already topped in 2017 and will weaken here on. Secondly, every time Europe grows incrementally faster than US, that is negative for dollar. This seems to be playing out in the coming 1 year. And finally, Fed's quantitative easing is bad for dollar. Currently, Fed is undergoing a quasi-QE program that will take a bet on dollar. The second key driver for commodity reflation will be global growth, which is expected to stabilize and grow up from here. Monetary policy across the globe has been very supportive, with major central banks cutting interest rates or expanding their balance sheet. Now, fiscal policy has also joined hands. The primary balance as a percentage of GDP is expected to grow up, both for the developed markets and the emerging markets. Also, global liquidity, which has been trending downward since 2018, has finally picked up. It is growing and it is growing fast. All these factors combined will revive global growth, increase the demand for commodity, and will be positive for the commodity prices. The third key driver of commodity deflation is commodity fundamentals themselves. Most metals have been in supply deficit for quite some time now. However, this has not reflected in their prices. This clearly shows that prices are depressed owing to sentiment. As the sentiment changes, the prices will grow up at much faster pace. Also, the global capacity addition in metals and mining has been very subdued. It did show some uptick in 2018, but is expected to go up at much faster pace in 2019. As CapEx comes back to metals and mining, it will provide more support to the upcoming commodity deflation. To add to it, the mining clocks indicates that the time is right now for commodity prices to grow up in coming months and years. Given that our hypothesis of commodity reflation is in place, let's see how we can play this in Indian markets. When commodity prices globally go up, the wholesale price inflation goes up. Historically, it's been seen that with rising WPI in India, the earnings and profitability of commodity companies grows up, and therefore they become a favorable investable space. If we look at copper to bond prices ratio and the NSE metal index, we see that they move in lockstep. For every 1% rise in the ratio, the NSE metal index goes up by 1.08%, thus creating a favorable investing opportunity. With dollar falling, the emerging markets will see a rally, which will benefit India both in the markets as well as on the economic fronts. Thank you.